Hopefully our game saves. This was fun, though.
Yeah, this is fun.
I'm having a good time.
Yeah. Having a good time.
Having a good time. Having a good time. I'm a supercut.
I'm a supercut.
I am a sex machine ready to reload like an animal. I sound like garbage.
Oh, there's no stopping me. I'm burning through the sky, yeah. 200 degrees, that's why they call me Mr. Fahrenheit. I'm traveling past the speed of light. I wanna make a supersonic man out of you. Don't stop me now, cause I'm having such a good time. I'm having a ball. Don't stop me now. If you wanna have a good time, just give me a call. Oh.
Hey.
Vulcan Laboratories. Okay.
Okay, yeah, that's where we were.
That's nice.
That's nice. Okay. I like that. Welcome back to the Analysis Arcade.
Are you going to let me get the reins?
I feel attacked. I feel that was too much.
You got to get their attention, man.
No. Okay, go ahead and try.
Hello and welcome back to the Analysis Arcade. Me and AJ are continuing our discussion on Star Trek Beyond. And so, AJ, what do you want to talk about next?
Well, that was an awful intro.
Thank you.
No, I want to talk about the style and look of everything. Because I mentioned it. Okay, back to what I was saying. Everything looks a lot more reminiscent to Star Trek than it did before. In the first Star Trek that J.J. Abrams did, it just was trying too hard to look futuristic. Mm-hmm. I think it's a good design. It just lost, like, the essence of Star Trek. But even with, like, look at the design of these uniforms here. It just feels like a shirt.
Yeah, and if, like, but, like... You see there's a little pattern. Yeah, you can't really see it.
It felt here. Like it felt too
they didn't feel like they were like a part of a team. They felt like they were like cuz they're supposed to be uniforms.
Yeah, yeah.
They're not supposed to just look like normal just wear.
Yeah, definitely. Cuz like in the in Star Trek Beyond, the uniforms look like uniforms. They feel like something that might actually be just...
They, like, go up to the neck and stuff.
Yeah, it feels like classic Trek a lot more, but it feels like a uniform. I don't know how else to say it. These just feel like kind of futuristic-y shirts. Yeah. And
but everything feels a lot more proper. And
even with the design of things, like I feel like they pulled a lot of like I could see this being a Star Trek episode that takes place. Well, okay, obviously it's much higher production value.
Maybe it would be like a Star Trek special.
Maybe. Well, no, I just mean like just looking at it, like the design, it just feels small scale enough. You know, like here's some random city that they go to, and it's got a very nice design, intricate. And it's really, like, it felt like something I could see in a Star Trek episode if they came out nowadays. Obviously, there's Star Trek nowadays, but like we said in the last episode, hate and despise it.
We hate but, Alex Kurtzman.
Yes. And he needs to be fired from
everything. Is on top of that crap over, in, you know, they just need a...
They need a...
Grow
a brain. So does Alex Kurtzman.
I don't condone murder, but
I thought you were gonna say violence. But murder, yes.
But I feel like this is a pretty necessary situation where Alex Kurtzman needs to be taken down from the reins of Star Trek.
Yes.
And given to Simon Pegg, man.
Well, I don't think Simon Pegg...
I would love those actors. Like, I would love all these actors, and if they were given in, like, a smaller scale adventure up in space. Yeah. Because I feel like it would feel... Like, the Star Trek Beyond would feel so much like a classic episode of Star Trek if they, one, didn't destroy the Enterprise.
I feel like
if the villain was, you know, a little bit...
He wasn't just another... I feel like if they did... Because I like that how he was... He used to be a captain of the Enterprise... Of the... Sorry, not the Enterprise. The USS Franklin. And he was a part of the Federation.
Yeah.
I like his character. It's just that the fact that he is just another bad guy wants revenge story...
It's
is just... Okay. Tiring, you
sorry
know?
it's about motivations, right? Mm-hmm. All his motivations are is, oh, Star,
well, he feels betrayed by the Federation because the Federation used to be a war unit,
yeah,
and so, and now that
he's, yeah, he's a conflicted person, and mm-hmm. I like the idea of the villain, but he just doesn't make me feel for him. You know, they bring up his past in, like, the last few moments before the final, you know, battle. And that just doesn't add anything to it if we've been watching a movie where I haven't cared about him at all. You know, I mean, and I think that's...
You see Kirk has sympathy for him.
Sympathy? Well, yeah, but, like, you know, like...
Because he understands, because he doesn't know what to... Because he doesn't kind of know what to do, because... He was just born into, you know, killing.
Hey, are you...
Where are you?
I don't know. I'm doing this thing. I think I did it.
Okay, you are over there.
I need to get in here. Oh, okay, I'm good. No, yeah. I think the villain could have been good if he had actual motivations that were set up from the beginning. Mm-hmm. But instead, it's just, we're going to show up and kill you.
Yeah,
I think the movie would have benefited if it was just a smaller scale story, like you mm-hmm. were saying, because that's what Star Trek always was. It wasn't like grand adventures until like some of the movies, but even then, like, those don't really always stay true to what Star Trek was. Yeah. Either way, what I want to say is that the movie could have been really good if it wasn't for that villain.
Yeah, I think it had so much potential.
Because it feels good, it looks good, like, I love the design, even, like, little things, like, how some of the, like, even the deck, or what am I thinking of? Like, the engine bays, it looks a lot more like classic Trek, rather than, like, a boiler room, which you wouldn't find in, like, the year 3000, but who cares? You know, it's, mm-hmm. you know, it's just, the whole movie just fixed problems that... Yeah. We had, or other people had, from the previous movies. And why won't this freaking dude die?
Yeah. I am solving the puzzle.
Holy crap. Freaking. Sorry. Yeah, and I think that's my favorite thing about it, is that it just feels like Trek. I feel like we've said that a lot, but
it's just like, it's just so nice that everything just feels like how it should.
Yeah, It's a nice change of pace.
It doesn't
pace.
Beg you to like it. It's not. It doesn't force you to, you know.
Yeah, in the last ones, it was just like, here's all these things that you should like. Please like it.
Yeah.
In this, it feels like, hey, here's a bunch of things that we know you like.
Yeah.
And know are good instead of trying to find something that they think people would, you know, go crazy
over.
You
watch Star Trek to watch Star Trek. You don't watch Star Trek to watch some... space, you know, drama, which Star Trek is kind of space drama, but it isn't so dramatic as it is nowadays.
Yeah, it's...
It's not an action, show.
I don't know what to do here.
I'm just...
Yeah, it was never, like, an action show. It was about the science fiction of it all, for one thing. A lot of... There is... Oh, okay.
It was trying to avoid conflict between, you know...
but in, now this, it's all about, I'm gonna punch you in the... face and all that crap, you know, like that's totally it, like it was about solving conflict, not just making conflict.
They're trying to solve problems, not make them.
I'm gonna show that clip of Rich Evans.
Who is this for? I don't understand how this is supposed to appeal to me, a Star Trek fan. I think Star Trek, it's the vision of a brighter future, Mike. It's a galaxy where humanity has gotten its shit together and we've solved all of our problems. There's no more hunger, there's no more hate, and we get along with the other races of the galaxy and we try to spread our diplomacy wherever we go.
Let's see what's out there. Engage.
Whoa.
I watched Discovery and I was all just, WAR! I'm gonna stab you in the fucking face! This isn't Star Trek.
And it perfectly sums up what we're talking about. And I'm gonna punch you in the, I'm gonna stab you in the face. Like, it's a bunch of stuff like that. And yeah. Once again, it brings out why I don't care for the character of the villain. Hey, I don't know where to go.
Hey, wait, I can boost your shields, but I think.
Oh, no.
Your vital signs are good.
Either way, we're kind of we're reaching the end, I think.
Okay, then your battery is kind of low.
Well, it's at 15.
Oh, okay. So, I mean.
But yeah, no. This movie, I think, was a step in the right direction, and then Alex Kurtzman took us 50,000 back.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's sad to see because this movie really did have potential, you know? And, like, it's like we said, the things that we love about it are the homages to the original Star Trek. And they did the complete opposite with where they went after. But I don't feel like, you know, that's anybody who worked on this movie probably isn't to blame at all. But that's what makes me sad is that.
Yeah, because it's
the
like,
person in charge is.
Because it's like a good budget and stuff. It's just, you know. Because right now, I mean, like, if. I just wish that if, like, you know. If Simon Pegg could just, like, be in charge of it, I feel like I would love Star Trek again.
Yeah, I don't even know what Simon Pegg is up to nowadays.
I don't even know.
I would definitely trust him with Star Trek. That would be my main thing.
That'd be my dream.
Yeah, this movie suffers from what all of Star Trek does nowadays, where it's too much all at once, and it doesn't focus on
characters. Gene Roddenberry's Roddenberry's vision.
There's not enough people just talking. You know, the stuff that we loved was Spock and. Spock and McCoy just talking, you know, and, you know, having fun together. And the action is interesting sometimes. There was one shot that blew my mind because I thought it was just, like, really, like, it was really cool. Like, there's a lot of stuff happening in this.
Mm-mm.
And the direction is, you know, a little at fault to why it doesn't feel as good as it could. But also too big, too grand of a story for me to focus on one thing. That, you know, because I find myself just being bored by, we got to get the bad guy.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I feel like if they would have just dialed it down, focused on the characters a lot more, I would have cared throughout the whole story.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that's, I think, the biggest problem. Where are you, dude? I am so far away.
I can tell. And
I've just been talking and walking.
I fought a bunch of enemies, and, I mean... Okay. I just, you were talking, so I didn't want to interrupt you, so you'll find your way.
Yeah, I have been talking a lot. Is there anything else, any last tidbits you want to share? Is this a door?
Not really. This was just a really...
fun conversation.
It was a really nice refresher. This movie was a really great refresher on just, like, of what Star Trek could be in the right hands, and... I mean, even if you take out all of the stuff that's happening now with Star Trek, it is really just a really good movie. And it gets my recommendation. I feel like if you're a fan of old TOS...
Yeah, and I think...
You will love this film. And I feel like if you do like more action stuff, there is plenty enough for you here.
Yeah, I think for me, you know, the biggest detriments are the big, dumb action stuff. But... It really does feel good to watch after, you know, the other ones because it actually pays attention to what Star Trek was. And that's, I think, about all I have to say. So, all
right.
Okay, thank you for sitting through us talking about Star Trek Beyond. It was a lot of fun for us. We hope you guys enjoyed it.
Yeah.
I know most of you are my friends, but if there's anybody new here, please like and subscribe. I would very much so appreciate it. If you think there's anyone who might enjoy this, please consider sharing it. It really would mean a lot to me. This is something me and Connor love to do.
Mm-hmm.
And if it goes anywhere, you know, there's only one way for that to happen. So we'd just like to say thank you for listening.